Section 4C of the body of knowledge of CQE exam is acceptance sampling. Since we are going as per the body of knowledge, section by section, there are some concepts which will be explained here. The details of those will be covered later. For example, sampling. So here we are talking about acceptance sampling, but the basic concepts related to sampling will be covered in section 6B1, which is later on. So in the reliability also, I ask that you go complete the course and come back to this section once again. Just like reliability, this is also a section where you need to complete the course, come back and redo this topic, because many of the concepts which we will be talking here will be covered in much more detailed in later sections. Example of that is sampling. Example of that will be binomial distribution. We will talk a lot about binomial distribution, Poisson distribution, but then details of those distributions will be discussed later. So do that and come back here. Now coming to acceptance sampling, what is the focus here? So the focus of acceptance sampling is to accept or reject the lot based on samples without quantifying the quality of the product or processes. So here we have a lot, we take sample from that, we test that sample, and based on that sample, we decide whether to accept or reject the lot. Let's look at an example. So here is an example of attribute sampling. And remember that this is the end of this topic, end of the topic related to acceptance sampling. This is what you will be doing once you complete this topic. So this example just shows that what all you will be learning here. So let's look at this example without going into too much of details, because we will be discussing these details later on step by step. So here I have a question that I have a lot size of 1000 pieces. So I get 1000 pieces from my supplier. So we have decided that the inspection level will be 2. And once again, we will talk about all these details later on. And then we have acceptable quality limit as 1.5%. We take 80 samples out of that. So out of 1000 pieces, we take 80 pieces, check them and see whether those are acceptable or rejectable. We look at these two tables. On the first table, you see that there is a 500 to 1200. So since my lot is 1000, so this will fall under this line. Looking at general inspection level 2, this will give me a letter J. So with that letter J, I will move to the next table and look at J and look at the acceptable quality level as 1.5 and come out with these two numbers, 3 and 4. 3 is the acceptance number. 4 is the rejection number. What does that mean? Now, once we have these 1000 pieces, we took 80 pieces out of that, we tested in the laboratory, and based on that test of 80 pieces, we want to decide whether we accept this whole lot or we reject this whole lot. That will depend on these two numbers. So if the number of items which are rejected are 3 or less, then we accept that lot. If the rejection item or the rejectable item in that are 4 or more, then we reject this whole lot. So the fate of this lot is decided by this sample of 80 and seeing that how many of these are acceptable and how many of these are rejectable. 3 or less, we accept. 4 or more, we reject this whole lot without going into the details of what is the type of quality in that lot. So this is what we will be doing in acceptance sampling. First, we will learn about basic theories related to acceptance sampling, and then we will look at specific codes and standards which tell and which give you all these tables to find out whether the lot is acceptable or rejectable. So with this overall understanding of the topic, now let's go back to the very basic and understand what is a sample, what is a population. So let's start with that in the next video.